Today we will talk about the vitamin D nomenclature. There are various types of names for various types of vitamin D, and which can sometimes confuse us. This video will try to remove that confusion. Now, the basic name used for vitamin D is calciferol. You have to remember that. Let's go back to how it is formed. It is formed in the skin through the conversion of the 7-dehydrocholesterol into cholecalciferol or vitamin D3. A few things to remember here. First is the UVB part of the sunlight is used in conversion, and 7-dehydrocholesterol is already present in the skin, which contains an all group, meaning thereby it already has a hydroxyl unit attached to the chain. So which gets converted into the cholecalciferol. Now cholecalciferol or vitamin D3 is basically the animal origin vitamin D, called as cholecalciferol. Now D3 stands for cholecalciferol and D2 stands for ergocalciferol. Ergocalciferol is basically plant-based vitamin D. Cholecalciferol D3 is animal-based. Now we come on to the next part of the synthesis. After the formation of vitamin D3, it undergoes first 25 hydroxylation in the liver and then 1 hydroxylation at the kidney. So D3 in the liver gets converted into 25 hydroxy vitamin D3, which is also known as calcidiol. How to remember this? There is a diol is attached to the to this name because the initial 7-hydrocholesterol already had a hydroxyl group attached. Now it has undergone 25 hydroxylation, so another hydroxyl group has been attached and it gets converted into the diol. So calcidiol is after 25 hydroxylation in the liver or 25 hydroxy vitamin D3. This will undergo 1 alpha hydroxylation at the kidney and lead to formation of the 125 dihydroxy vitamin D3 or calcitriol, which is the active form of the vitamin D. Calcitriol, remember triol, because already had an hydroxyl group and then got 25 hydroxylation at the liver and then 1 hydroxylation at the kidney, and now it is called a triol. A quick recap. Basic name for vitamin D is calciferol, and animal based vitamin D is vitamin D3 or cholecalciferol. Plant based is D2 or ergocalciferol. Now, 25 after 25 hydroxylation at the liver, it will become a diol, calcidiol, and after 1 alpha hydroxylation at the kidney, it will become 125 hydroxy vitamin D or calcitriol. Now let's also study the RDA for vitamin D. Easy. This is easy because in normal adult it is 600 international units per day. For infants it is 400, and in adults it is in elderly above 70 years of age it is double of 400. Just remember 600, and in infants it is reduced 200 to become 400 and add 200 to become 800 for elderlies above 70 years of age. Now the normal values when we test for vitamin D, we always test for 25 hydroxy vitamin D, and the normal levels are usually mentioned in nanogram per ml, and the normal range is above 30. So between 21 to 29 it is insufficiency, and less than 20 is deficient. Now some labs also use other values which are in nano mole per milliliter. You can remember, or you can just learn that you get the nanomole value by just multiplying the nanogram values with 2.5. So the normal range will be above 75. The insufficient range will be between 50 to 75, and less than 50 will be the deficient range for nanomole per ml values. So that's all, folks. Thanks. Please leave comments to start a discussion. Thank you.